Hold on, because Will, I didn't bring this speech, so Will has it on his phone. Is he? Everybody hang in there.
We have to go away. I have nowhere to go. Okay. Oh, I have this in my pocket. Thank you.
It's called Ryan Wedding Speech. So I'm not sure how the structure of these speeches are supposed to go. I know that there's like a wedding speech like thing where I'm like go up here and I roast Ryan. And I'm like, oh, this guy, he's a great guy though, or whatever. And I've seen like a lot of like copy-pasted Google searches, like best man speech, and then it's like, don't let your wife catch you leaving dishes in the sink, like shit like that. I don't think that that works for Ryan and Rachel. I think that Ryan defies that structure. I think that Ryan defies pretty much everything and everyone. Ryan has the most passively rebellious spirit of anyone I know. It's, for me, unbelievably admirable and also difficult to put into words, so here we go, I'll try. As a young man, Ryan was somewhat akin to Melville's Bartleby the Scrivener. Yeah, that's right. I'm gonna make Melville references. I have a master's in fine arts. Because his refrain was often, I'd prefer not. If you wanted Ryan to do something, it's very likely he'd prefer not to do it. He did plenty of stuff, I assure you, but asking him to do something would be the worst way to get him to do anything. That doesn't mean he was or is lazy. Ryan is selectively active. Like a lizard that can sun on a rock for days at a time before hunting, Ryan can play video games in a dark room for an entire Christmas break, which he did one winter in Grand Theft Auto San Andreas was vanquished. Truly the craziest thing ever, wasn't it? Judging by Ryan's appearance, the assumption is that he's the weird one of the family. He is not. I'm definitely the weird one. Ryan's hair has been a constant source of intrigue and amazement for over 13 years. Family members don't know how to react to it because it just seems to shift, grow, and at one point change colors with the rhythm of the tides. Ryan, people would say, when will you cut your hair? My brother, steadfast in his personhood and resolute like the founders of America, would reply, I don't know. Why should he know? And why should he care? Mainly, that's what Ryan does for all of us. He allows us to ask ourselves, why care about the bullshit? Are you allowed to swear in these best man's meetings? We know we shouldn't care what others think and how the timeline of our lives compares to the timelines of our peers, but we always do. Ryan doesn't, and it's glorious. What a self-aware and content human being. This is what I mean when I say his life and choices are admirable in a way I can't verbalize well enough. The funny contrast to my brother's super chill nature is his ability and seeming delight in inflicting massive amounts of pain in other human beings. probably well known by most of us that Ryan was the Connecticut State Wrestling Champion at 189 pounds in 2001. He dislocated his shoulder in the championship match with about a minute to go, up by a few points. He popped his shoulder back in the socket and held on to win, pink hair and all. Some would understandably attribute Ryan's success in wrestling and lacrosse to athleticism and skill, but as his little brother, I know it was the pleasure he took in hurting his opponents. I don't think it's some sick, twisted pleasure, more of an elementary joy that if he bends your elbow far enough behind your back or sprints at you with a stick raised in the air, you will probably scream and give up. Ryan and I are opposites in many ways. I love public speaking. He would prefer not to. Ryan is awesome at math and building stuff. I am useless. I am an absolute physical specimen. that's what I was looking for. Ryan has a body. It definitely is in the physical human form. But we have always agreed on a few things. One of them is humor. Ryan is really funny. I'm sure that most people here would agree that my brother is hilarious. He has understanding that life deserves to be laughed at. If we didn't find the humor in most things, we would certainly go insane. Ryan is too smart to not point out the ridiculousness of this existence. And I can't speak for all of us, except Val. But I can say that I am ecstatic for Ryan and Rachel. You found each other through some shifting of the cosmos. I could never conceive of a person that would captivate my brother as well as Rachel, or even a person that was singularly captivated by Ryan. It is one of the profound and utterly beautiful mysteries of life, and we should all be grateful for their opportunity to partake in just a little bit of their love for each other. That's the toast.